Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Elyon, Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same, by the power of your name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Kom Kono, Adonai. I will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai. Through your love and through the ram, you saved the son of Abraham.
Hey, 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 and praise God for this glorious day. This is Zach Mitchum, your host of What Jesus Says. I want to welcome you back and being so faithful and joining us every Friday evening at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to learn more about what Jesus has to say on controversial issues facing us today. This is the day the Lord has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. And we're glad to have you back. And we're so excited about things are turning the curve and more people are vaccinated. And we're looking up. Everything's looking up. And I feel that the Lord is answering our prayers. So, and that's a great segue. Let's go into the throne room and ask the Lord to heal our land and bless our people. Lord God, we thank you and we're grateful, Lord Jesus, for everything you've done for us. We bless your name at all times. Your praise shall continually be in our mouths. We pray for those that are less fortunate, Lord God, those in hospitals, nursing homes, hospices, homeless shelters, those incarcerated, unemployed, sick in their mind, the body, bedridden, those that are on death row, that you give them peace. We pray for your apostles, prophets, evangelists, preachers, teachers, local and universal. We pray for our churches, local and universal. We pray for our president and our vice president that you give them favor, Lord God, in all matters to govern this country. We pray for leaders all over the world. We pray for our enemies that they cease from troubling. We pray for the peace of Jerusalem that we prosper, that love the holy city. Peace be within our gates, prosperity in our palaces. We pray for the salvation of Israel that they come to know you as their God, Lord, and Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray for our soldiers, sailors, airmen, and marines, and all our men and women that stand in the gap for our safety, that in uniform, Lord God. Now we turn this broadcast over to you, that you get all honor and glory in Jesus' name, amen. If you want to participate in tonight's conversation, dial 919-747-3572. That's 919-747-3572. And this is Zach Mitchum, your group leader for the night. And what Jesus says, we're talking about gratitude tonight, amen. We're talking about gratitude. Hello. Hey, 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 who do we have on the line today? All right, you locked, cocked, and ready to rock. You ready to go?
Yeah.
Who else do we have on the line? We don't have our other caller yet.
Get that.
Okay. Well, we'll be patient. Tonight we're talking about gratitude. Do you know what gratitude is?
Grateful.
When you're thankful for something.
Yeah.
Gratitude. Let me see if I can get this other call on the line. Let me, you know what? I'm going to go to break and then we're going to come back. How about that?
All right. That's fine.
Okay. Let's go to break and we'll be right back. Devil is a liar.
All right.
Nail pierced hands, wounded side. This is love. This is love. Holy heart, sacrifice. This is love.
Hello.
This is love. I bow down to the Holy One. bow down to the Lamb. I bow down to the Worthy One. I bow down to the Lamb. The Son of God died for us. This is love. This is love. He walked the hill. He bore the cross. This is love. This is love. I bow down. I bow down to the Lamb. I bow down to the Worthy One. I bow down to the Lamb. I bow down to the I bow down to the Lamb. I bow down to the Worthy One. I bow down to the Lamb. I bow down. Down to the Lamb. I bow down to the Worthy One. I bow down to the Lamb. Jesus, I bow. Pierced hands, wounded side. This is love. This is love. A holy heart was sacrificed. This is love. This is love.
Hallelujah, that's love indeed. So do we have everybody on the line now?
Yeah.
Okay. Next time I ask you if everybody's on the line, somebody better say something.
Okay.
Listen. We got a praise report, man. And you got to be careful how you get these praise reports, because sometimes people are like, wait a minute, is this a praise report or what? I told my mother, I said, they took Derek off life support. She said, oh, I said, no. I said, he's doing everything on his own now. So you have to be careful, don't you?
Yes.
You got to have the right message, because you take somebody off, that means sometimes you gave up on them, right?
Yeah.
But on the other hand, we just saw you can't be presumptuous or take things for granted that people know what you're talking about, because you take them off and they're doing it on their own. That's a good thing, right?
Yes.
Hey, look, we're talking about gratitude tonight, all right? Amen. You got anything to be grateful for?
Like, period. Salvation.
salvation, hallelujah, and life, and that's something. Look, some people aren't great. Some people don't know how to show gratitude. That's a problem, isn't it?
Yep.
And, you know, even if you just say thank you, people have a sense of, hey, they'll do it again, right?
Right.
But when you just take it for granted, you know, you just did your due diligence. You gave me some money, whatever. They didn't have to give you that, did they?
No.
Let's talk about gratitude. We're going to go to Luke, the 17th chapter, 11th verse, starting there. And now keep in mind, we're talking about gratitude. Don't forget that, because you're going to be graded at the end of the broadcast. You know that, right?
Yes.
What are we talking about tonight?
Gratitude.
What? We're talking about gratitude. That's right. Gratitude. Yep. Okay. Don't forget. Listen, I ain't playing with y'all. Don't forget. You're going to get a grade. If you want to participate in tonight's conversation, dial 919-747-3572. This is Zach Mitchum, your host of What Jesus Says. We're talking about gratitude. Luke 17, 11th verse. Here we go. And it came to pass as he went to Jerusalem that he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, which stood afar off. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he said unto them, go show yourselves unto the priest. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back and with a loud voice glorified God and fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks. And he said, and he was a Samaritan. And Jesus answered, said, were there not 10 cleansed? But where are they? Where are the 9? They are not found that return to give glory to God, save this stranger. And he said unto him, arise, go thy way. Thy faith had made thee whole. Now, there's a lot in there. There's a whole lot in there, okay? First off, let's see something. Now, it wasn't legal for people to be up on you with leprosy, right? So they said they were standing afar. Do you understand what that means? They were far off.
Yeah.
How do you think they recognize Jesus from far off? See, when the spirit is around, people got a feeling that things about to change in their life. That something's going on. That must be Jesus, because a regular person doesn't bring that kind of power. You understand? But they said they were far, and they yelled with a loud voice. He wasn't close to them. And he yelled back to him, yeah, he didn't touch him. He didn't pray for him. He didn't say nothing. All he said was, look, go show yourself to the priest. Isn't that what he said?
Yeah.
Now, he made a comment. This is talking about racism. Did you hear what I said?
All right.
We're talking about racism, because some people can't receive from you if you're in a different package or if you look a different way, if you got a different hue of your skin, right? And the word, when he makes mention of something, he's bringing out a strong point. He said, and there was one person that came back that was cleansed, and he was a Samaritan. That means that at the time, the Jews had nothing to do with Samaritans. It's like Peter was called out for that, because he wouldn't even deal with the Gentiles at all. I mean, the Lord had to reprimand him on that, and so did Paul, call him out on it. And so he said, wasn't there 9? Wasn't there 10? What happened to the 9? You mean to tell me nobody came back except this stranger? That he called him a stranger. In other words, he was not a part of us. And he said, a prophet is without honor in his own country. His own countrymen didn't even come back and say, Lord, thank you. He says, shouldn't they have gone and give God glory for their salvation? Huh? So, and that's what he's telling you. A lot of times the Gentiles are going to rejoice greater than those that are in the covenant, because they done never recognized who was walking amongst them. They didn't know that God was in their midst. Do you understand? And the people that were happy were the people outside the family. He said, Lord, thank you. And he said, go that way. You've been made whole. In other words, in other scriptures, it said he was made whole. That means, I don't know about those other nine, but he didn't say those other nine were made whole, did they?
No.
But he said that one was made whole. That means nothing missing, nothing broken. That means you, not only did you get healed, I'm going to take care of something else. Might be your finances, might be your housing condition, might be your, just showing gratitude, you can get a whole lot of extra stuff, can't you?
Yeah.
Now let's chew on that for a while. We're going to come back and talk about it, but I'm going to play y'all something and let you listen to it. And we're going to thank God. It's like, dear God, I want you to know, I want you to thank you for my life. And then when you show gratitude, you'll get altitude. You understand? So let's listen to this. We'll be right back.
Feels so good to make it this far, and I didn't think I could take it so long. There were days I wanted to quit, and I said, surely this is it, but I held on, and I've watched as so-called friends turn and walked away, and it hurt so much I didn't have words to say. But even when my day turns to night and nothing seems just right, Lord, I thank you for my life, for my life. Lord, I thank you for every victory in you I've seen, and all the moments I know, Lord, it was you who kept me. So I thank you for my life. And I've watched you take my family from there to here. And when times were a little rough, God, I know you were near. Thank you, Jesus. And the moments I thought I'd fail, I was reminded of your nails. So I held on. And if I never live to see another day, there's nothing I would change or take away. I've had so many ups that they far outweigh my downs. Lord, I thank you for my life, for my life. Lord, I thank you for every victory. Oh, and for the moment, God, I know you kept me, yeah. Lord, I just thank you for my life. I realize some didn't make it. I could have been one of the ones who lost my way. And then
Lord, I know I almost went crazy. Oh, but I'm still here, oh, with my life. So for my life, Lord, I thank you for every victory in you I've seen, hey, and for the moments that I know you kept me. Yes, Lord, it was you who kept me. So I thank you. Thank you, Jesus, for my life. It may not be all that I'd hoped for, and every dream has not yet been realized. But to see your face one day, God, I know it's all gonna be worth it. Every valley, God, everything that you brought me through, thank you for. I know it was you, God. I just want to take the time to say thank you, Jesus, for my life. For my life.
Hallelujah. Can we take a praise break and give him some honor and glory for thanking him for our life? Can you hear me?
Huh?
We want to thank Jesus for our life. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Amen. Let's take time out to thank him. For those that don't know the Lord, he says in Romans 10:9, if you confess with your mouth, Lord Jesus, believe in your heart, God raised him from the dead, you're saved, because with the mouth confession is made to salvation, with heart belief is made righteousness. Romans 10:9 says, if you confess with your mouth, Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart, God raised him from the dead, you're saved. Because with the mouth, confession is made to salvation. With the heart, belief is made unto righteousness. And we believe that. And we also believe in Luke 11:13. It says, you being evil know how to give your children good gifts. How much more will your Heavenly Father give you the Holy Ghost if you ask him? Now, if we go back to that scripture we were reading, we go to Luke 17. Starting with the 19th verse, it says right there, it says, and he said unto him, arise, go thy way, thy faith has made thee whole. So what do you think being made whole means to you? What does that look like to you, being made whole?
Made complete.
Say it again.
Made complete.
Complete, no doubt.
Yeah.
Anybody else have any comments on it? Being made complete, exactly. Nothing missing, nothing broken. Sister Mitchell, you got anything? Did she hang up the phone?
No.
Okay. Let's see if she's still on the line. But what we want to know tonight is that, I want you to know tonight, is that with the Lord, all things are possible. And without him, nothing is possible. And it's impossible to please the Lord without faith. Do you understand that? Do you understand that it's impossible to please the Lord without faith?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is what we're going to do. we're going to wrap this up because I don't know if she can still hear us or not. But we discussed for the last 20 minutes what it means to be grateful. And when you're grateful, you'll show it with your attitude.
Thank you.
You understand? So when you receive anything from the Lord, it's incumbent on you to show gratitude by being thankful and showing that thanks through some means, worship, praise, glorifying Him that gave you all the things that you have. And when you do that, it gives you an opportunity to demonstrate to the Lord that He's not being taken advantage of or in vain. You understand?
Yeah.
Even when you go through something, don't you want to think that when you give somebody something appreciative of it?
Yes, Lord. Yeah.
And so if they just take something from you and take it for granted, you might have needed that money, right? And
right.
And then, you know, you gave your last piece of change to them because they said, look, they were getting ready to cut their lights off or something. You know how they do. And you came to their rescue. And as a result of that, they took it for granted that, okay, well, that's my sister, my cousin, or whatever, your relationship with them. They didn't say thank you or anything. I mean, it just took it for granted that you were going to always be there for them, right?
Yeah.
Well, see, that's great with the Lord, but with people are different. They're fickle, right? They don't always show up for you. So what we're going to do, we're going to end the conversation by saying, hold on, let me see if we can get this person back on before we end and try to add them back on the call. Now, prayerfully, we can get them back on collectively if they answer the phone. They're unavailable. But we're going to leave the broadcast like we always do with Shirley Caesar taking us out. How about that?
All right.
All right. Here we go.
Well, teach me, Master. Master, teach me. Oh, teach me how to wait. Oh, when I bow at the altar. Oh, teach me what to say. Live a liar. I tell you the reason why I'm afraid my Lord might call me. Oh, yeah. And I would be ready to teach the master, teach me. Come on, Master.
Teach me, Master. Teach me.
You know that sound good right now. Listen.
Teach me, Master. Teach me.
Oh, teach
me how to pray.
For I would not be a gambler. And I'll tell you the reason why.
Come on, Master.
Teach me, Master, teach me.
Come on, Jesus.
Teach me, Master, teach me.
Teach me to pray.
Teach me, Master, teach me.
Teach me to walk right.
Teach me, Master, teach me.
Teach me to talk right.
Teach me, Master, teach me.
Oh, teach me how to pray.
Okay, thank you for joining us. We look forward to having you again next week for another edition. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.